With this one or any storm system that moves through, it's not just the temperature at the ground that determines what type of precipitation we see, but what's going on in the upper levels of that storm system as well. High in the clouds, even well into summer, the liquid is frozen as ice crystals. Of course, when we see rain, there's enough warm air at the base of the cloud and down to the surface that those crystals melt into raindrops. When we get freezing rain, there's a thin layer of cold air below 32 degrees right near the surface. So even though through most of the atmosphere that rain is falling as liquid, as it makes contact with the ground or anything that's on the ground, our houses, fence poles, roadways, it freezes on contact because it's below 32 degrees. Similar, but just a little different in terms of the depth of that cold layer near the surface. If it's deep enough, generally more than 800 to 1,000 feet, those raindrops freeze into solid ice balls or ice pellets. That's what we call sleet. And when we get snow, of course, the ice crystals are not allowed to melt all the way down to the surface. Either there's very little warm air near the surface above freezing or none at all, so they stay falling as snowflakes.